Hello, I'm known on the internet as Basov, and today I will replace the LCD panel in my Lenovo ThinkPad T490s. This guide should also work for T480, T480s and T490. My model features a non-touchscreen Meta Full HD IPS panel. As you can see, it is broken. There we go. It shows static pretty much. Please note that after you perform the steps of this guide, your warranty may be void. I hold no responsibility to the extent permitted by the applicable law for any particular damage caused by your actions while following this guide or otherwise. First, let's consider the requisite that we need to fix our laptop. A laptop with a broken screen. A panel replacement. I got mine from https://screencountry.com. I recommend their website, the staff were helpful and the delivery was quick. Please note that they gave me $20 discount for making this video and mentioning them. A plastic shim, card, or a screwdriver with a flat head. I recommend a plastic card because a screwdriver may damage your bezel. Optionally, you can get scissors for opening the package. And also optionally, you can have a secondary screen that we may use to disable the button. Okay, let's start. According to Lenovo's manual, link in the description, we need to disable the battery. Enter firmware settings. To do that, turn on your laptop and press F1 repeatedly until you hear a beep. There goes a beep. Now, please note that the screen may turn off at any point. That means that, That means that you need to start over, so you need to be quick while entering the combination, so preferably you can memorize it and then enter it really quickly after you see the colors change. First I will tell you the combination and then I will enter it. You need to press down twice, press enter, press tap 4 times, press enter, press tap twice, down, enter, then F10 and enter. All of the combinations will be in the description, by the way. Let's do it. Now our setup is switched to the external screen. Plug in the external screen, turn the laptop on, press F1 repeatedly until you hear a beep again. Now, as you can see, our laptop is using our external screen. Now we can just navigate it as usual to disable the battery. Go to config. Power, disable built-in battery, and press yes. Please note that you should disconnect your computer from AC power first. Now our battery is disabled. Disconnect all cables, and let's start the main part. By the way, if you don't have an external screen, or if your laptop is in text mode, there will be some key combinations in the description so that you can disable the battery without an external screen and do so in the text mode as well. I would like to warn you that after this step, your warranty will most likely be void. The official manual recommends you to remove the whole LCD unit before removing the panel. While it might be more handy to remove the bezel this way, it's not a requirement. Let's start by removing the bezel. I will take my plastic card, you can use a screwdriver, but I don't recommend it, and carefully pry the bezel off. Start at corners. You need to pry it from here. Carefully remove the bezel flap by flap. Don't mind that it bends, that's fine, it won't break. But don't pull it too hard either, because it will break then. Know that the bezel is glued to the panel, so be careful while taking it off. it's glued at the bottom more than it is on top, so. Okay, great. Now we have removed the bezel, we need to remove the panel itself. First, carefully take it off, it's disconnected. Now, we need to disconnect the panel. First, remove this bit of tape. Then, take your flap or screwdriver, this time it doesn't matter, and pry this little holder up. There we go. Now disconnect the cable and pull it from the socket. Please be careful, if you damage the cable, it will be very hard to replace. Okay, great. We have disconnected our panel. It can go in the landfill or be recycled, whatever you wish. Now let's get to installing the new panel. Alright, I have opened the package for you. Now you can see that the screen protector is scratched and there are bubbles. Don't worry, it can be taken off later. Place the panel like that. Connect the cable. Alright. I have connected the cable, snap the holder back in, and, well, this bit of tape doesn't stick anymore, but I don't think it will be a problem. Now place the panel up, it should fit, yes it does fit. Now this step is pretty important, we will remove our screen protector, then place the bezel and snap it back in. Please be careful while removing the protector. If you really want to, you can leave the protector in place, but it will look awful. Alright. Unfortunately, I didn't have a meta panel for my replacement, so I chose the glossy one. Now, let's snap the bezel back in place. We have snapped the bezel back in place. Now, to enable the internal battery, we need to plug our laptop into the socket. Okay, great, it seems to be enabled. Now turn it on. If the external display is not available, it will choose the internal one automatically, and there we go, it works. Now let's check that everything works fine. And yes, okay, everything works as expected. Now, again, huge thanks to screencountry.com for providing me with a display and a discount. And that has been Basalt. Take care. Thank you.